The island of Tenerife, in the Canary Islands archipelago, is a famous tourist destination known for its volcanic beaches, mild climate, and the majestic Mount Teide, the highest point in Spain. With its imposing presence, Teide is not just a postcard image, but also an active volcano that has shaped the geography and history of the region. Beside it lies Pico Viejo, a subsidiary volcano that, although dormant since the late 18th century, still carries a past marked by eruptions that transformed the landscape into a nearly lunar scenery. This geological complex is closely monitored by scientific institutes, as seismic activity has always been part of the island's dynamics. It was in this setting that a new seismic swarm drew attention. In the early hours of the morning, more than 700 tremors were detected in just 5 hours in the area of Las Cañadas del Teide, southwest of Pico Viejo. Although they were of low magnitude, the high number and short duration of this event raised concerns among specialists. While authorities assure there is no immediate risk to residents, it is impossible to ignore that these underground movements are signs of internal changes in the volcanic system. The National Geographic Institute recorded that all the quakes occurred at an average depth of about 6 miles, 10 kilometers, and were not felt by the population. This means that only seismic monitoring stations detected the events. Many of these tremors were so weak that they were not even included in the official earthquake catalog. Still, the mere fact that they occurred in large numbers indicates that something is happening underground. This was the sixth seismic swarm recorded in Tenerife since 2016. Previous cases occurred in October 2016, June 2019, twice in 2022, and again in November 2024. All happened practically in the same region, raising questions about a possible trend toward increased frequency of such events. Scientists point out that not all seismic swarms lead to an eruption. In the case of Teide, current data do not indicate increased volcanic gases or ground deformation, which would be clearer signs of imminent risk. However, experts stress that each volcano has unique behavior, and what appears stable today may change quickly depending on the movement of magma and fluids inside the crust. This movement, according to researchers, is linked to the injection of magmatic and hydrothermal fluids into underground fissures. It is as if the volcanic system were breathing and reorganizing itself. The phenomenon has been observed in other episodes since 2016 and remains a point of attention for the scientific community. Pico Viejo, where much of this recent seismic activity is concentrated, is known for its 1798 eruption. During that period, which lasted about 3 months, the volcano expelled lava in an effusive way, creating extensive rock fields and forming cinder cones known as Narites del Teide. Although it significantly altered the landscape, that eruption did not reach coastal areas or cause major material losses. Since then, the volcano has remained quiet but not inactive, as tremors and underground movements continue to occur. Recent seismic maps show that most epicenters are located southwest of Pico Viejo. This concentration indicates that rocks in the region are fracturing, allowing gases and hot liquids from inside the volcano to pass through. For geologists, this is concerning because magma and fluids tend to follow the path of least resistance, and recent fissures can become ascent channels. The depth of the tremors ranges between 5 and 9 miles, 8 to 14 kilometers, which is typical of the magma accumulation zone. Although the maximum recorded magnitude of 1.5 seems small, this value should not be interpreted as the absence of risk. In volcanic systems, energy can accumulate slowly and often silently until a larger event releases this pressure. Authorities stress that there are no signs of a short-term eruption. There has been no perceptible ground deformation or abrupt increase in gas emissions, two important indicators in volcanic monitoring. However, experts remind us that underground processes can develop over decades before generating an eruption, which requires constant vigilance. Tenerife's monitoring network is considered one of the most advanced in Europe, capable of detecting even the smallest seismic movements. This gives emergency teams the chance to act in advance if more critical indicators are detected. Investment in science and technology is seen as the main tool to protect the island's residents and visitors. Even with official assurances, the episode reinforces the importance of not underestimating signals coming from inside the Earth. The history of the Canary Islands shows that major eruptions can be preceded by years of discrete activity, and each new event is a piece of the puzzle volcanologists try to assemble to predict Teide's behavior. The study of recent seismic swarms reveals that there were two distinct patterns of tremors in this event. The first, shorter one, lasted about 3 hours and recorded 55 quakes, the strongest with a magnitude of 1.5. The second consisted of hundreds of low-energy events linked to the movement of water and hydrothermal gases through underground fractures. This difference helps us understand that the volcanic system is dynamic and involves more than just magma movement. Experts classify these tremors as having a hybrid and volcanic tectonic origin. This means they result both from adjustments in the Earth's crust and from processes directly linked to the presence of magma. It is as if different internal forces were acting simultaneously, generating complex patterns of activity. Although there are no clear signs that an eruption is near, the recent behavior is consistent with that of active volcanic systems. Small tremors may indicate that fluids are circulating and accumulating pressure in specific areas. If this process intensifies, it could lead to sudden changes in the volcano's state. Tenerife's history shows that there is not always a predictable sequence before an eruption. The case of the La Palma eruption in 2021 is an example of how seismic activity can quickly evolve into an eruptive event, even without long warnings. Therefore, comparisons between different volcanoes should be made with caution. Researchers estimate that the probability of a Teide eruption in the next 5 decades is between 30 and 40%. Although this may seem like a long time frame, in geological terms it is relatively short. This reinforces the need to keep the population informed and prepared. Meanwhile, residents and tourists go about their routines, trusting the work of specialists. Communication between scientists, authorities, and the public is essential to avoid unnecessary panic and ensure that if something changes, the right measures are taken in time. The phenomenon recorded in Tenerife serves as a reminder that living near an active volcano requires constant attention. Pico Viejo and Teide, with all their grandeur, are more than tourist attractions. They also represent geological forces in motion, capable of drastically altering the environment in which they are located. The more than 700 tremors in just a few hours are a sign that the volcanic system is active, even if there are no immediate danger signs. Science allows us to interpret these signals, but it is still not able to predict exactly when an eruption will occur. That is why continuous monitoring is the key to minimizing risks. Each new seismic record feeds databases that help volcanologists understand Teide's behavior. This work involves not only technology, but also interpretation and comparison with past events. These studies are essential for adjusting prediction models. The geological history of the island shows that previous eruptions occurred after long periods of apparent calm. This means that a stable scenario today does not guarantee permanent tranquility. Nature's patience can last decades before releasing its accumulated energy. The episode reinforces the importance of education and awareness among the local population and visitors. Recognizing warning signs, understanding evacuation plans, and trusting official guidance are attitudes that can save lives in an emergency. If you are interested in science, nature, and geological phenomena, it is worth keeping a close eye on what is happening in Tenerife. The study of this episode may reveal valuable information about how volcanoes work and how we can coexist more safely with these impressive forces of the Earth.